Oh, this has really been one of the toughest days here at JBTV.
Good friend and a loyal person here at JBTV who found music that means something in these walls.
I look at these walls, and Chris was here for all these shows, or a lot of these shows, you know. He walked through these halls. His stuff is still here. His JBTV jet, his clothes are here. All his stuff is here, just as he left it.
And he was here for 7 years. His name is Chris Vicente. He's a JBTV viewer, and he came to a show, and on the first show, I put him on camera. I says, I need a camera person. And there was Chris. And he's been here ever since. He's only missed one show, and that's because he was out of town visiting his relatives this last year. And thank God he did visit his relatives, because it was the last time that they'll have a chance to see Chris.
And who would have thought, for me doing a health awareness show, and Chris being so part of what we're doing, that he's now in the hospital in critical condition.
As of today, he's in a coma. And it's tough, you know. I survive stage 4 cancer somehow or another, and he's in a coma with a massive stroke, and it doesn't look good. And over there, he'd be on the couch right now, probably snoring, you know. And it's quiet here. It's amazing, you know, the family here at JBTV, it's a one-of-a-kind place. And you realize that life is short. I sure found that out. I had, you know, my deal, but cancer is nothing compared to what Chris is going through right now. 45 years old. You know, I'm 68. You know, he did so much here. He worked relentlessly, you know. He was our biggest supporter. You know, he like all of us, are going broke on this little thing we call JBTV because, well, quite frankly, music is the last thing. You know, it's therapeutic. Got me through cancer. It's getting me through cancer, and it gets people through everything. It's getting me through this depression that I'm going through now. But I'll be okay. Because, you know, just to have had him here for 7 years was a blessed event. And every day he made it so special, you know. We miss you, Chris. If there's a miracle, you know, it'd be nice if it could happen right now. He recovers somehow or another. But, and it's amazing, his last year he spent a lot of time out there, you know, not partying, but, you know, being with people. And he went on a trip. I know he was proud and fun. He had a good time with that. So he was living his dream, and you know, like that movie Almost Famous, or I hope that's the movie. He was living that rock and roll dream, and every day hundreds of people come through here as volunteers and interns, and it's just been a labor of love, you know. And when you have a family member that has going through hard times. It's difficult. So we'll all be praying for you, Chris. And it was so, we were in the hospital today and he had so many friends. It was just difficult, you know, to see him like that because he was so strong. He seemed, you know, he's Chris, you know. But I told him, you know, when I was in the hospital, when I was checking out, I asked the nurse to take his blood pressure. She said, well, he's not a patient. I really can't. But she did anyway, you know. And she said, you have to see a doctor. In the hospital, when I'm getting discharged, and I'm going, Chris, this is the best hospital, Northwestern. They'll take good care of you. And now he had a massive stroke, you know, out doing some thing. Life is short, and I'm going to dedicate a show totally to Chris.
The studio is just not the same. Here in the editing suite, just as Chris left it.
You know, I looked at his desk, his stuff is still there, you know, where he left it, just as he left it. Everywhere you look around JBTV, you see his stuff, you know, it's everywhere.
And everywhere you look, he shows up.
We made fun of him a lot. He, you know, he's such a pack rat, you know, he'd be on this couch over here snoring. Watching the television. If there is a God, please save Chris. And if it's God's will to, you know, be there with all the great rock stars, then I hope he's hanging out with rock stars.